Today we've got the one show coming into the PTC in York, and to see how we can make a chocolate teapot, and if you'd like to come behind the scenes to how we've achieved it. Thought process wise, we've been playing around with ideas and thoughts for quite a while now, probably 6 weeks from a thought process. I've used dark chocolate with 65% cocoa solids. The reason for that is the fat content. That will hold it better, it will create this film on the inside better. We need to work out at what point the thickness of the chocolate will retain the heat from the water. So we started off by doing a balloon experiment where we take a balloon, we then dip it into some pre-prepared chocolate. We then need to take the excess off the bottom of the balloon and stand. So then what we then did was we did this once, we let it dry like this one here, and then dipped it a second time, and then we did it again and again, and we tested to see how many layers we require before the water would come through the chocolate. If you get the right thickness of chocolate, what happens is the water temperature cools down slightly and it then retains the heat inside, so it doesn't leak and doesn't melt. Some of the other challenges were the amount of hole in the top. So if you've got a very small gap at the top, the steam can't escape. So we found that by increasing the hole at the top meant we could have a thinner shell of chocolate. The next challenge then was actually putting it into an actual teapot. To create the actual teapot, we made a mold. So we took a teapot, cast it in silicone to create a two-part mold. We then filled that up with chocolate, making sure that the handle and the spout is solid. We then fill it with chocolate, so we tip the chocolate into the mold so it's full. We then shake it to take out any air bubbles. Then we turn it upside down and drain out the excess chocolate back into the bowl. And then we repeat that until we've got the right thickness inside here. So what we're doing inside the mold is kind of the reverse of what we're doing with the balloon. Whereas when chocolate is poured into a mold, the heat from the chocolate has to escape in order to not get a balloon. And when you've got silicone there, it takes a lot longer. So it takes quite a long time to make this teapot. 2.5 hours, roughly, from start to finish. We then drill a hole through the spout, so it has a much thinner hole through here, so that again we're keeping the thick walls, otherwise the spout would just melt really fast. What we found is that when we first started looking at it, is that we'd probably end up with a chocolate tea. Interestingly, that if you pour the water in a certain way and you don't stir inside and you just let it settle and let it brew like you would normally brew a cup of tea, and you just let it stand for a little while, then when you pour it, what happens is the chocolate on the inside of the shell melts, but doesn't move anywhere, it stays where it is. So you get a very, very small amount of residue coming up to the top. You can see.
It's tea. What? It's a little bit sweet. It's a little bit of chocolate going on. A little sort of hint of chocolate. That's quite nice actually, I quite like it with a bit of chocolate in.
Perfect.
Perfect, well done there. Proof positive. You can make a teapot.